All right, guys, welcome to another edition of Last Humans Tech. And here is the portion of the channel where we review tech-related products, electronics, computers, things like that. My Super Tech is a totally different channel, actually called Last Humans Tech. That's for the Linux, the Unix, the programming, the tutorials, if you want to learn how to use Linux and Solaris and things like that. This is, the tech on this channel is more lower stuff, just tech products more so. So today, we have the Wallfire. Remember, I did review another Wallfire. See, when you get my age, you don't really care who sees how fat your belly is anymore. You know, you'll see when you get older. All right, remember we had a Wallfire review of an item a week or two ago? I can't remember. This is another Wallfire item. This is a 3-in-1 lens for an iPhone, and I really am psyched to see if this works, you know. Before I struggle for five, let me get this case off. I'll be right back. All right, guys, I'm going to try and attempt to show you the wide angle lens and the difference it makes right now. So I just want to show you exactly what we have in the camera right there. You can see that it starts at the wood pole and ends on the other side halfway through the larger drawers, okay? Now I'm going to try and hold it still and reach around and clip this lens on. I think that's centered. That's not quite centered right. One sec. There. Now, same spot right here. The wide lens does work. You can see you now have extended view on the side of the pole, and you're not seeing half of the big drawer in the toolbox now. You're seeing the whole thing. So that is like the difference. Let me take it off right here and you can watch. Let me try and get the glare off it. And you can watch it actually shrink. Ready? And it got bigger. See that? This is cool. It has a little indent in here, so it fits into place over that little lens outcrop there. So and of course that doesn't affect anything. You can move it wherever you want out of the way, and now all of a sudden you have widescreen photos from your iPhone that you can take. Okay, one more quick demonstration as I got a real good view now because the sun got covered for a minute. I'm going to go ahead and take off the attachment here and let you see how the wide angle goes away. Ready? Oh yeah, this works. This product is sweet. And you know the iPhone 7 camera is pretty good, so, and there is no distortion when I add the wide angle. So really, it's just giving you the opportunity to take even better iPhone 7 pics. I just gotta always look at it to make sure I get it centered right. And this really works. I'm surprised. It's pretty sweet. Okay, and we'll test the light later. For the macro, you're just going to unscrew the top half of the lens here, and you can see here it's a Li-Q 0.4x to 0.6x wide angle lens, if you can even read that. And you take off this part, and you do have a little cover that came with it to protect it a little bit. And then you have what I assume is the macro lens instead. And of course your big flash that I have not charged up, which is why it isn't going to work yet. Oh, whoa, this is already charged. I didn't know that, guys. And it has three brightness settings. See if you can tell the difference. So I'm press it three times. On, medium, brightest. You can see the aura around it. This would be really good for night. Let me see if I can blind you a bit to show you. I mean, it isn't blinding, but I think it would help with those LEDs. I didn't know that thing was powered up. Small, medium, large. Small, medium, large. This thing is slick, man. As the first test of the macro lens, which is not installed yet, see it says 15x macro on it. Let's just do a fingernail test, an easy one. I don't want to do my blisters because that's kind of gross. My fingernails are gross too, but not as gross. So let's just check out the focus point, okay? Let me get the glare off it a little bit. There we go. So it's good. I'll move it closer and closer. I'm losing focus already right here, so I can't go into any nail details whatsoever, okay? Without changing anything, no tricks, pop on the macro. I think it's in place there. Let's go ahead and see what this thing can do. Oh my God. This thing works, guys. Look at that. You have never seen an iPhone focus that close before. Oh my God. Now the Mac, this is really, truly a macro. You really, I mean, look, I'm this close to the lens, okay? You really gotta need macro if you're gonna put this lens on. You could see every detail, every wrinkle, oh my God, of my nail, all the nasty dirt from all my car work. You gotta get it just right there. That's what focuses. There we go, there we, wow. Macros, and there's just so much reflection, it's hard to find the right spot. So let's just do this right here. So you see, nice and clear, nice and beautiful. Let's go in here, and you can see right about when the blade gets about 1/3 of the lens, it loses its focus. Then you pull out right here, it's clear. Right here, 1/3 of the lens, it loses its focus. All right, fish in here, clip on the macro, which is simply you screw off the wide lens and automatically you have a macro. Okay, it's locked in place. Let's go ahead and zoom back in here. See, this only works macro though. So remember, we could only do a blade about 1/3 of the screen. Whoa. If it wasn't moving, I could get a better focus. Look how close you can get. I'm moving it too much. Oh, let's see. You get almost the entire blade taking up the entire screen, and it's in focus. Big, big difference in this stuff. Big difference. This definitely works. This is really cool. You could never get, the lens is basically on the frickin', look how close it is, on it, touching it, and it's focused. That's super clear. I'm gonna try and snap a couple pics to put up in the video later. All right, so that's the macro portion. It looks pretty killer. The wide definitely works too. This is a good product, better than I expected. There's a link down there if you wanna just read about it a little bit, get some details. It's super cheap, and hey, it works for the widescreen. There's almost no reason you wouldn't want a widescreen taking any of your pictures. It just makes for a more robust picture. Then you can zoom in with your resolution, cut it, and you have higher quality overall. Sweet product by Wallfire, the 3-in-1 camera. The light I didn't test. I'll test that at night sometime, but I don't really need to test that right now. And there you go. Thanks for sending this out for review, and it's pretty cool. I'll definitely be using it. I wanted to clarify too that I do have my case back on here, my Spigen, and it does still function with the case. Now it doesn't snap in a nice circle like it should, but this is the macro. It still functions with the case. Let me spin on the wide lens real quick and just check that one too. It's a tight fit with that flash lens. See that? It's a little bit tight fit. You gotta get it just right. There we go. All right. Pop off the cap, and yeah, even let me just get it straight on there. Okay, so even with the case, it still works. That's some serious widescreen right there. Can I get a glare off it? Not really. It definitely works with it, so you don't have to remove your case all the time, which was probably a lot of people's concern. And you have the super widescreen. I need some ethanol bad, guys. All right, I'll see you next time. It does come with a nice storage bag, so you don't have to worry about having it flop all over and get scratched. You do have a storage bag there. Put it right with your camera accessories, and you take it to go.